particular for a couple of reasons. One is that it's in Massachusetts, which is sort of the cradle of American liberty, and also it's a vacation town. It's a summer resort, so that it has a year-round population of more or less working class people. And then in the summers, holidays, weekends, tourists from the city who come bringing much needed money, but are also always looked upon as outsiders. Main character in the novel is a man named Mark Firth. He works as a contractor, so he fixes up old houses and restores their period details. Mark falls under the spell of an outsider, an out-of-towner from the city named Philip Hattie, a very, very wealthy hedge fund billionaire of the sort that Mark dreams of becoming. Mark has a very American idea about himself, which is that he should want to improve his lot. He should want be rich and to leave his children better off than he was himself. His relationship with Hattie it takes a few difficult turns, and not everyone in the town of Howland is as pleased to see Hattie there as Mark is. It's a novel about social class, for sure. I mean, I don't know if it's the middle class specifically, just the relationship between rich and poor in America, particularly the skepticism, but also the worship with which the people sometimes look upon the very, very wealthy, and indeed want to be governed by them. So it's a novel, like all my novels, I think, are about the conflicts between classes in American life, particularly because the one of the founding myths of American society is that it's supposed to be without class, it's supposed to be democratic, but in fact the reality doesn't bear that out. It is a political novel, and I can't take credit for having predicted the rise of Donald Trump. I started the book in 2013, but the anger that gave rise to the election of Trump, the sense in the middle and the working class, particularly that the anger that something has been taken away from them, that was around before Donald Trump, and sad to say, I think will be around after Donald Trump. As has the idea that billionaire businessmen would make great rulers. That before Trump came along, there were several other figures in American life: Ross Perot, Steve Forbes, Bill Gates, people like that. People are eager to put themselves in the care of. There's a sense that rich people may be suspect, but really, really rich people are somehow morally pure, which I think is an interesting American idea that has been around for decades. The novel opens the day after 9/11 in New York City, and the first section of it is narrated by a nameless figure, a kind of underground man in New York, who seems at first like he's going to be the main character, but actually turns out to be the figure who introduces us to Mark. And I wanted the book, I had the idea from the beginning that the book should be, it's a book about the early years of this century in American life, and I wanted it to begin with 9/11 and to end, it ends just a couple of weeks before Occupy Wall Street, and the final scenes of the book, without giving too much away, are a kind of echo or a reflection of those events. I wanted to write about the movement from what seemed like in a time of crisis, a great sense of fellow feeling and patriotism, to a very short time later, that sense of populist anger, the sense of distrust in not only government but in common action, in the idea that your problems are my problems. It seemed a remarkable political reaction to me, and I wanted to try to portray it in miniature in this one small, very fundamentally American town.